put it back to where it was, you have to use the existing soil. So in order to stop noise, they used it. Our noise levels are 75 during the day is what we're legally allowed to have, and 35 at night. But that is measured at the nearest domestic dwelling, which is not that one. It's the one at the end of the track. Right now, we'll probably be around 80, I'd imagine. I'll tell you. And that's to be measured at the nearest house. So we're within our planning regs. Quite merrily for that. When it's actually producing, that's another reason to get rid of the known donkeys, they squeak. They do get the ESP greased up every day. With an ESP, there's nothing. Absolutely nothing.
ESP?
Electric submersible pump, sorry.
Well, it's full of
got three welfare cabins for the guys, which are the two green ones on the far side and the big long green one. Then we've got a little office, we've got a gas monitoring one, and then we've got a Halliburton logging shack. So those are our three. We've got our little lab, etc. Logging.
Right.
Logging.
And then what do you do?
We're not coring. No, coring is too expensive. To core, you have to draw a new formation. You basically take what looks like an apple corer and you do that as opposed to drilling with a, you know, just drilling it in.
And then, so what's logging?
So logging, okay, so that's where you've got Halliburton here. So inside, a lot of the tools that we have came out of the oil industry, MRIs, are helpful too. And basically we want to see what the rock looks like. Is it naturally fractured or is it not naturally fractured? The resistivity of the rock tells us if we've got oil, gas or water. The neutron density tells us how much hydrocarbon we have in formation. And we have a caliper log as well to tell us how big or small our hole is in case we're washing out the side or anything like that. We've got a pressure monitor downhole. We've got a temperature monitor downhole. We've also got survey equipment, so you've got three magnetometers and three accelerometers that sit like that, so you can basically tell your azimuth and your inclination. And then you've got gamma ray measurements. We've got two types of sonic tool in the hole. We've got an ultrawave, which is designed to effectively tell you the fracture, and an X-Bath as well, which is another sonic tool. Basically, just little clippers, old style. But they work.
So it's basically data collection.
Yeah, it's all data. It's, yeah. Logging every, you drill a well to log it as a first point of call.
In terms of the work that you're doing now, this piece is going to end in a couple of days' time. This is the lining of the well, just putting
this
it back
liner
in
goes down successfully, doesn't get stuck. It'll be down tonight, and then it'll be cemented up in place.
And then you will be able to produce oil from Portland straight away?
No. Have a tank in there.
Right, so, but in theory, we could. It's just, yeah, we've got the infrastructure there.
We have to put the infrastructure again. We removed all the infrastructure before we did all this because we had to redo the buns and get everything in a better condition.
Yeah.
So we stripped out all the wiring. All the wiring on the site's gone.
Yeah.
Okay. All the old plumbing's gone, and all the old subsurface drainage tanks, etc., which didn't have interceptors, they've all been removed as well. Which is half the reason why the place looks so dug up. You walk along there and you'll think it looks horrific, which it does, and I apologise. But basically we've been digging and digging and finding lots of bits and bobs and taking them all out. As soon as they're gone, then we can start levelling the site, putting the stone back and making it look a bit better.
And then you'll be able to produce oil from the Portland?
Yes.
Yep. You don't need any permission to do that? That's conventional?
Not from the Portland, no we don't.
No. So that will start when?
Only 2-3 months.
Meanwhile, in order to do the investigation in Kimmeridge, you need permission to do that.
No, we've logged the Kimmeridge and we've logged the Corellian. So we've logged all that.
So the next stage is to analyse that and then work out whether you can produce from it. And if you can produce from it, you then need permission to...
And then we have to put an addendum, a field development plan together to the authorities and they have to okay it.
Does that go through... I mean, if there's any, would there be anything that needs public scrutiny within that?
I'm not too sure. To be honest, I don't do the planning. I'd imagine so, because we have to put in, for anything, we usually have to get public consultation.
Well, if anything that goes through Surrey County Council and minerals and...
You get environmental...
is public, isn't it?
All that sort of thing. Yeah, no, everything's public in this world. Well, in the UK. Yeah.
And so, but the point being, in order to produce from the Kimmeridge, you would need to make an application to drill. Would you produce?
No, I could produce out the old wells. I'd have to re-perforate. I'd have to recomplete. I'd have to put new pipe
in. You couldn't produce out of this well?
I'd have to put a completion in it. So I'd have to run, I'd have to get a rig back in. I'd have to run a completion into the hole, and that would enable me to produce.
Right. But you could produce out of Kimmeridge now?
Yes. No, hold on. I'm not allowed to. I'm saying, and we don't know if we can. But yes, theoretically, in an old well you can, yes. So, but you'd have to prove the integrity of the old wellbore as a first point.
But in terms of drilling a sidetrack, which you'd have to do to produce...
To actually produce properly from the Kimmeridge, you would have to do production sidetracks here, yes.
Yeah. And you would need permission to do that?
Yes, you would. Yeah.
So the talk we've got of a mile-long sidetrack coming out from here, David Lenigas...
We've got several that come out from here already.
Right, OK. But you're not utilising any of them at the moment?
We're utilising the one on the number 3 well. It comes out, it goes, loops around that field and probably comes in the corner there, I think. I could be wrong. I don't even know how to shoot here, to be honest. And that one comes out at an angle as well, that rather goes to the Kimmeridge. That does come out at an angle, but these aren't wells that go out. There was a sidetrack on that well that we've abandoned that went out probably 400 metres. But that's been abandoned. And we've got the existing one out, which probably goes out maybe 200, but it goes at an angle like that. It's an exploration well. So if you were drilling in the Kimmeridge, then one would have long horizontals through the pit.
This one that they talk about is K1X, which is the... It's on
X4.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yes,
Where's that?
That is that well there, that's X4.
Okay, so
sidetrack it would be X4Z.
Because in the map, which is quite a high level map, it's got that going up in kind of that direction.
Yeah.
How long is that going to be? The X4Z sidetrack.
About 100 metres maybe? If that. We can't leave our little carbon and make a block without going for red line permissions.
So you can't drill underneath, outside the boundary?
You can, but you have to go for permission.
So whatever you do, you just need permission?
Yeah, you always have to go for permission.
And red line permission is because you're going out.
So, yeah, no, not out of our block, but so we lease this. If we go to the next landowners, then we have to basically go and have a word.
So could you drill under the village?
Theoretically, yeah. Drill under London.
But there's a lot of land on this evening.
Yeah, I'd have a hell of a time. I mean, you can do it. I mean, physically,
but you have to get permission from all the landowners.
I don't know the legalities, but it has to go through the council and everything else. It's not just a tick box exercise. I'm not a lawyer, and I don't really like that side of things. I like that.
All right.
So I mean, I can find out.
I'll answer the question. They were shooting out of the pool.
Don't put my voice or face on video, you can sodomize me. No, I'll be as straight as I can with you. I mean, I won't interfere with your protesting and whatnot, and you guys have the right to do it. I'm perfectly comfortable with that. And all we can do is try and alleviate your fears. We know you're not going to, obviously, you can't take our word for it either, so here's what it is.
I think, like I say, Well, what happened at Horse Hill for me was the biggest concern, really.
Is that thing off right now?
Nope.
Can you turn on for a sec?